On this episode of Replay, we're taking a look at Traveler's Tales, Haven: Call of the King for PlayStation 2. It was published by Midway. Hello, everyone. I'm your host, Andrew Reiner. I got Ben Hanson here.
Hello, Reiner.
Jeff Cork.
We're going to answer that call.
And Tim Turi, my go-to guy for playing the game.
I'm going to play this game.
I think you're going to like this, Tim. This is one of those games where I just kind of think of the games you like to play, and I think you're going to get into it to a certain degree.
Okay.
Traveler's Tales went all in on this game, wanted this to be a big new franchise for them, and it flopped miserably. I enjoyed it. I reviewed it. I think I gave it an 8-something. Really ambitious. All sorts of different types of gameplay, whether it's standard platforming, shooting, vehicle stuff, flying. It has everything in it.
When did it come out?
It came out in 2002.
Okay.
And it was originally going to come out on... we're playing on PS2. It was also going to come out on GameCube and Xbox, but they got canceled. And it came out November 17th, so that tells you what time frame they were thinking of, like, when this game was going to hit.
Right.
During the busy holiday season.
A little Sauron up there? What's going on?
Yeah, that's the eye of... well, it kind of looks like a snake or a bug or something, too.
Eye of Moron.
Yeah, whoa, that was hey. The version. That was the name they went with.
You should preface it with more like... That makes those funny.
More like,
oh, yeah, you're right. So, Reiner, what do you mean they went all out? Like, in preview coverage, were they really selling this? Like, this
oh,
is
yeah, they
the...
wanted this to be huge. They thought it was going to be, you know, stand toe-to-toe with, like, Crash Bandicoot and Jack and Daxter, you know, the big games of the time.
It kind of has
platformers.
That. It has that... I'm getting, like, a Ratchet, Jack and Daxter vibe.
And this, I don't know if you remember, but Midway had another platformer around the same time. Dr. Mudo?
Oh, yeah.
And that flopped as well. And that was kind of the beginning of, uh-oh, Midway.
Oh, geez, Midway. Stick to Spy Hunter, kid.
That'll be, Overlord, to disturb me at this late hour.
Forgive me. We are getting alarming reports from one of our mining towns.
He's a Skylander, I think.
Portable power.
Do you remember what you gave this, Reiner?
Like a 8.25?
Okay. So you're a defender of this game.
Yes.
You answered the call.
I thought it was good.
Okay.
Lost in the mists of time. I know, sire.
It's got like a Palpatine Vader thing going on.
Nice camera work.
About the voice.
Yes, sire.
Gah.
That's going to be my new chair at work, by the way.
What if Gah was one of us?
We'll be working on the fourth floor. I'll be on the fifth.
The voice must not be heard.
He's got like scorpion tails.
I think they're scared to show off these character designs.
Shall I have the slave executed?
It's called mystery.
Oh,
yeah.
Not used to this whole concept of tension.
This made me turn to the General Grievous.
You apologize now, Hanson? Because they're clearly zooming in.
You're right. It's a regular Sebulba type face. We got Sebulba here. It looks like a horse's skull.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh.
Meanwhile.
Colors.
Cauldron.
Oof. This is Gak.
Red cornrows.
So that was Lord Vetch.
Son of a Vetch.
Gets the call from the Overlord.
Oh, boy.
Okay, I see the Jack and Daxter thing a little bit, especially with the soul patch.
Oh, yeah.
Terrifying.
That should do it. Put him back in.
Come on. Oh, what's wrong with you?
He's like a troubled soul, too.
A little Anakin in him, huh?
Hero.
I give that Anakin. Little speech every morning when I wake up, for the record.
I'm late for work. I'm going to be in trouble this time.
Got to go to the jerk store.
The jerk store?
Oh,
come on. His little buddy wanted to help.
Help he
him.
Just built him, and then like seconds later, he's slamming the door, and it's little robot
gotta
face.
Gotta go. Oh, no.
Oh.
It would be Skimpton. I bet he's still mad.
So does that bird thing fly around with you? Is it your Navi? Is it like a Mark of Cree type situation?
That's Talon.
Okay, he looks
that's
real
your buddy.
Cool.
He was lucky. My pickaxe hasn't been sharp. It's his only friend.
Uh-huh.
No, I'm just kidding. So Vetch tells, or the Overlord tells Vetch that there's a boy in the world that knows about something called the Golden Voice.
No,
so they're going to go track this kid down. So that's where it starts, with a bit of mystery. What's going on here?
Don't sneak directly in arm's reach of the guy that you owe money.
Oh. Please don't look at the background. Please don't look at the background.
Look at these tribal tattoos instead. Pretty extreme.
Gonna be feeling a lot worse.
Oof.
I make that the third time late this week.
Weird looking.
Oh, his hands. Hey, hands are tough, everybody. Hands
are
tough.
I'm looking at like the 10 hairs coming out of the mole on his chin.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, Robo Bird.
You didn't see that kind of mole detail on PS2.
No, you did not.
Go for his bum leg.
Wow,
there it
look
is.
At that. Oh, he fell in the bucket. Oh, boy.
Glide, 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 glide.
And you say Tim will like this kind of game, right?
Yes. Hey, I haven't started playing yet. We'll see.
Just because you like 3D platformers? Is that the connection?
Yes. A lot of collectibles, different things to do.
As far as a hero goes, he is despicable looking.
Yeah,
he is just awful.
Can you collect new facial hair? Just stick it on one piece at a time like a Woolly Willy?
Just fill out the soul patch.
Go, man, go.
Ugh.
And I'm going to flash the box art. They clearly had a slightly different version of the character in mind, but it was still awful.
Sup.
That guy's cool. Looks like he's from Star Wars.
It's got a weird
take this, blow dryer.
Toothpaste gun.
See you on Jabba's sail barge, kid.
Pleasure skiff.
God, those cornrows, man.
Yeah. That's right. Yeah, it's an avalanche. I get it. You have
go!
Oh, it's Crash Bandicoot.
I love how this has become synonymous with Crash. Running towards the camera or anything. It's like, oh, it's the old Crash
it's
Bandicoot.
The worst.
That's because they did that.
Get the Brachiosaurus eggs. So you got a double jump. That was kind of cool, that clear gel back there.
There's a not very punctuated double jump, so that's happening, in case you're wondering why I'm just kind of gliding across.
That's weird. I hate double jumps that don't add any height. Even Devil May Cry, the new one, kind of has that feature where it's not really getting you to any far-reaching places.
No, it's pretty substantial in Devil May Cry.
What do you guys think of the double jump in general, though?
Love it.
Love it.
Conceptually,
it
doesn't make sense?
Yeah, how it doesn't make any sense, yeah.
Health
but it's
bar.
Still awesome in games. It's a lot of fun.
Multiple lives.
I liked the way
video
they did
games.
It.
Spread guns.
In Devil May Cry 1, where there was like the ruin that you'd jump off of, like it turned red, like right below him, so it looked like he was actually leaping off some invisible platform. Well, I guess it would have been visible.
This
but.
Looks familiar.
It's the opening of Shenmue, the title sequence.
Did you become a real bird? Is this the villain?
Hey.
Bird here.
Burden up this little tower. Just gonna stretch my feathers. Oh god, what is that thing?
Did he ring it?
Weird shaped bell.
Huh.
You got birded.
All these character models.
Well, this is what happens after a successful run away from an obstacle you knocked out somehow.
Yeah, I love that was the action-packed intro. It was really the beginning of Mass Effect 2. It's just stunning.
Oh, God.
The thermometer in his GD hair.
Maybe you should doctor your teeth up a little there, pal. God. What nonsense. Some Chun-Li buns? No, it's a stethoscope. I'm sorry.
Common mistake.
Little Tesla coil thing back there.
This would be really great if they like had shaved off his cornrows. And like, just kidding, we wouldn't create a character that looks like that.
It looks like they
jack
did.
Wig.
Yeah. It looks like they did. Like the hair underneath the cornrows.
Oh yeah, he's got like a Commander Shepard buzz cut underneath there.
So this game probably inspired Traveler's Tales to do mime action from now on out.
They can never talk again.
No, we saw it happen last time.
Although, the only way we'll ever have voice acting is if we take it from one of the most successful movies that's ever been made with the most lovable characters and great actors.
This all ties into Cork and I. We were just at Traveler's Tales over in England.
We were.
Remember when we went to England together?
Yeah, that was fun.
You have your
fun.
Own Traveler's Tales.
Yeah. How about you tell one of those now, Cork?
Well, I had a mincemeat pie. They were very small and delicious.
Yeah, it turns out they're tasty. There's very little
story.
Meat involved. You know, the entire time we were over there, they did not mention this game once. In fact, I did not even know this game existed.
No, I think they lined up everyone in the courtyard and told them it was a pleasure working with you, and then shot them in the head.
You're saying that there wasn't like a gigantic statue of this Haven dude with the cornrows like detailed?
Its head was cut off like a Saddam Hussein statue.
Yes.
People were throwing shoes at it.
And this predates Traveler's Tales with their cool little TT logos. We'll flash the beginning of the game here real quick so you can see the old logo they had.
If there's an opposite to the new logo, it is it.
It almost looked like that was like a character they wanted to create and never did anything.
Laconic
with.
Wolf.
So how big was their studio?
It's pretty big. Yeah. It's this was made
back in the old studio that they used to call the barn, which they said was just falling apart.
They called it a
cold.
Barn because it was in a barn.
Yeah, it turns out it was
colloquially known
barn.
As the barn.
When you look at it from the outside, it looked like a barn. And there's a picture of it in our History of TT Games video feature, which is on the site.
Yeah.
You can see what it actually looked like. And they developed the first Lego Star Wars there as well.
Yeah.
And then the new studio, it's bigger and it's pretty nice, but it doesn't really stand out.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, so he has an interesting weapon. It's like... almost a yo-yo.
Okay.
See that? You really have to center Ooh. Yourself on those things to pick them up, don't you?
Look at that.
Huh.
What's up, guys?
Kids love defense.
Captain America.
Check this out. Everyone loves a shield.
But it looks like it's made of spit.
Come and wonder at my shield. Oh, God, Jesus. Does nothing to just harmless NPCs. Okay.
So there's villains just walking around the NPCs?
Oh, you're done. You're done. What about your friend?
Liberate
wow.
them.
Just solidarity. Oh, sorry. Excuse me. All right.
It's like each person in the town has, you know, an agenda for the day, and they're just going about their merry business.
Yeah.
They have lives of their own. You can just see it.
This guy's done.
Tracing out the letter Z on the ground all day.
And then clipping through the ground a little bit.
I'm doing a K.
Music says it's not terrible,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah, enjoying it.
Oh.
You died because you broke a pot?
There's different...
Smacked your face in the pot.
There's different levels of pots, I guess. Pots are the main enemy in this game. There's blinking pots. You got some
stink
fire pots.
Very Crash Bandicoot.
You got boxes. You
Mrs.
know,
Potts from Beauty and the Beast.
These regular Potsy pots.
From Happy Days. For all you do dads out there.
You want those.
Oh God, unrelenting. You cannot escape.
So, Reiner, before I went on the Traveler's Tales Lego trip with mm-hmm. Jeff Cork here, was always curious about Wrath of Cortex, the PS2 version of Crash Bandicoot that Traveler's Tales developed a year before they made this game, because I remember reviews were pretty lukewarm to negative on it, and mm-hmm. I was a huge Crash fan on PS1. So I checked
Crash
it out.
Bandicoot.
Crash Bandicoot.
Sorry.
That's what my t-shirt says. And it was not as bad as I imagined it being. It looked... hideous, but they mirrored kind of the structure in the gameplay of the Crash 1 games pretty well.
That's nice. Actually how he said it to the guy who worked on it, too.
Yeah.
And it was like, my name's Ben. I'm basically a huge
No.
He was like, oh, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be.
I gave him that exact speech where I'm like, you know what? I remember reading reviews, and I'm sorry, but I didn't check it out back then. But I played it, and you guys did a really good job. And
no,
he
that's
said,
not how you said it. I had it on tape, and I listened to it, and I was transcribing. You were like, eh, you know, it's not that bad. I think you guys got kind of a bad rap on it. Meh.
But the guy we were talking to said that they made that Crash game, the first one outside of Naughty Dog, in 10 months. Which is pretty remarkable.
That's 1 month more than a human baby.
Correct. And then they submitted it for certification on September 11th, apparently, and it got delayed.
So what are you doing there, Hanson?
2001.
Or, Tim. Sorry, guys.
What are you doing, Hanson?
It's a good question.
I'm talking about 9/11. What are you doing,
holding
Tim?
Holding down a circle and trying to jettison out to get that cog, but it doesn't seem like that's what's up.
I wonder if you have to do the double jump at the end?
I did it, yeah.
Did a triple jump?
It didn't go. So, maybe,
if you grab it too quick, you get a little cog burn, and I don't think that's what you're looking for.
Oh,
here.
Cog burn.
Maybe you need to call the king.
Oh, is he answering right now? Come on.
The pot's the ultimate haven.
It's call of the king, not to call him.
Oh,
but that'd be a much better
that's
game.
Just
I think.
Nitpicking.
Call of the king, comma maybe.
Hmm.
Oh
Tim,
well.
Let it go. Let it go, buddy.
Well, maybe grab that thing in the center of the arena.
It explicitly told me to get three cogs, so...
That thing would...
You're very
cognizant.
Oh, stop. Yuck.
Why like a little gun now?
Hanging out in the room with Tim, it just brings out...
The worst.
The bestish.
Those almost look like fireworks more than bullets.
Come on, that's definitely a
Why don't
thing.
You walk up the side there? There's all kinds of pots and whatnot. See?
Oh, I want that thing!
Just go over to the brother.
What are with all? What's up with all these pots?
Try shooting one.
No one's talking about this. Are these bad? Okay, there's different colors of triangles, and
wow.
I have a gun. All right.
All right, walk up to the side.
Okay, ricochet.
Maybe you want
thing.
To.
So Reiner, why do you think this game didn't take off? At the time, I'm sure it wasn't too bad.
The controls are kind of clunky.
Uh-huh.
Nobody
oh,
liked
God.
The character.
Oh.
I think every review started with some comments about this guy.
Yeah.
And this is in the day and age where everybody likes
the
their
side.
Fuzzy little mascots, right?
There you go.
Nope. I guess so. Yep. A little Daxter in there. The name
Wait,
has to be
what?
A culprit as well.
Yeah. Haven.
Come on.
And you'd think you'd be able to get up that little side area because there's, you know, the doodads on it and everything. My doodads. That was really dumb. All right.
All right, so we're looking for what, two more?
Yeah, so we know where one is, and then...
Yeah, you probably get like a rocket pants or something like that.
Let or you... the bird will help you in a special boost.
Yeah.
What's frustrating...
You guys are kind of on the outs right now after the whole bully thing.
What's frustrating about games like this is when... especially this generation where everything wasn't just like straight, you know, hard, like right angles and clean geometric shapes. It's like, you don't know what's like, look at this example back here. Like, why can't I go back there? You know?
Right, yeah. You still see that some today.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Bethesda. The games have been done a better job of leading you along and trying to keep you away from those spaces. Right.
Yeah, definitely. And it was this era that I think was struggling with it a little bit, whereas like, you know, Mario 64 or even like Spyro was a little bit more clean cut.
So you played that like, play a lot of Skyrim lately, and I immediately want to jump diagonally up that, and it would take like 5 minutes, but I know that you can do that.
Just slowly slide up.
Yeah,
probably what the developers wanted.
Desperately. They're so happy.
So Tim, obviously you're perplexed by the different pots and collectibles and stuff like that. Back in the day, it was just kind of like, yeah, gotta get these things.
Yeah,
you had to do it, didn't you? Like have collectible
okay,
stuff.
Okay, so this is where you want to put them. So you want to put three of them here. So you got one, and still you need three.
Yeah.
And it looks like there
is a good way to... No. Nope. Well, we know where one other one is. I'd really like to get all these cogs.
Jeff Cork, what do you think the worst game name of all time is?
The worst game?
Corpse Killer.
Okay. Infinite Undiscovery.
Ooh,
it's pretty bad.
That's good, that's good. I'm going to go with Planescape Torment. Really? As much as people love that game, that is the dumbest name.
No.
It's not doing it any favors.
Tattoo Assassins? That's pretty dumb.
What? What is that?
It's an old fighting game that was like a Mortal Kombat ripoff with like 10 million fatalities.
And everybody has tattoos?
Yeah. The tattoos come to life. That's your power.
Oh, I've seen that.
And so also, you like one of the Nancy Kerrigan-like character has like a fart attack. it's
a tattoo
insane.
Of a fart?
No, it's like a straight up fart.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's not a puff of smoke going down the side of her leg.
Yeah, you won't be able to go back that way.
Okay.
Nancy Kerrigan character.
Yeah, it was pretty relevant at the time. Judge Ito.
Isn't Nancy Kerrigan in StarCraft?
Yeah.
Okay.
Correct. She's the Queen of the Blades.
Oh, that's what I thought.
Queen of the Ice Blades.
That's where the cog was, or the machine. Oh, he kind of spins it as he runs.
That's
yo-yo.
That's nice.
Yeah.
We got a bunch of yo-yos in the office recently.
We did.
I'm not just talking about new hires
so
or anything.
Fun.
It's just...
all right, let's see if we can figure out this thing.
This is
you
just
need
a,
some kind of extra
And we
power
all
up.
Complain about tutorial today, right? Like,
but here we do.
Man, games hold our hands way too much. A little help here would have been nice.
Yeah, I also prefer when games make sense.
How so? How does this not
see,
make sense?
See, you clearly cannot do that.
There's something wrong here.
You need something to let you do it. And it's not perseverance.
Yeah, I'm wondering if there's a button press I was missing or something.
It's R2 and you get to push the left stick.
I think
at
it's
the
off
time.
Button. Actually.
Is there a map, Tim?
Why, look at this.
Use the Meg Rider. What is that?
It's that thing that, that purple...
The pot?
Sky stream thing that you'd...
Oh,
drag yourself across.
No, these are your missions. Okay.
Yeah, okay. Collect three cogs.
Just like Skyrim.
Great.
Just like it.
You like Skyrim? You like dumb fonts?
Check out
Haven.
I think that might be the Meg Rider. That,
What?
That pot might be the Meg Rider. I don't know.
You think so?
There's might no be. Way to pick up and move that
I
pot.
I think the Meg Rider is that thing. It's like that fancy pants zip line that you used to get across the right. The,
yeah, can you
river.
Jump on that one?
Well, no, it says grind over the river. That's the cog I got earlier. That you're referring to.
Can maybe you jump on that one?
Mag ride it up, bro.
Oh, wait. Can you jump in pots? What is this one?
Real-time weather effects.
Mm-hmm.
I like the little bounce off the top.
It's just going to hurt me. Wait. Oh, okay. They all hurt me except the ones that progress the main storyline. Good.
That tree is really distracting. Bulbous, I'd argue.
L3 button. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Not
this is on
PS2.
PS4, by the way, everyone.
Wow. Yeah.
Launch title.
Five shoulder buttons on each side.
Wow, I get those. I get it that those buttons exist, and I should hit them to exit. Yeah, okay. Gotcha.
So you guys excited about that rumor that they're going to redesign the PlayStation controller for PS4?
Yes and no. I mean, I've used it for, what, 12 years, 13 years. I'm comfortable with it.
It's seriously one of the reasons if you ask someone, do you play it on like a game that's available on multiple platforms? You play it on PS3 or 360. I like the PS3 controller better, so that's what I play it on. So let's just revamp that.
Yeah, I don't mind them changing it up a little bit. I mean, obviously there's the boomerang example, which didn't go quite as planned, but Tim, you seem like a guy that prefers a 360 gamepad.
I do.
Is there any reason for that?
It feels better in my hands. But it depends on the game, too. I don't know. Like, Devil May Cry, for example, it was always a, you know, PS... God, this is just... Anyway, it was always a PlayStation game, and then I switched over to 360 for 4, and it actually worked out pretty well. But the D-pad, obviously, for PS3 is much preferred.
Yeah. Reiner?
Yes?
What do you think about this game here?
I think I already talked about it.
Correct.
You've asked... He said it 3 times now.
I know. No, I was trying to prompt him to maybe...
Oh, we haven't... We gotta get the cogs.
We gotta get the cogs, right, Hanson.
All right.
I don't know where you gotta be. Oh, wow, look at that. Chain reaction. Give me a cog, damn it. Cog,
you
damn it.
The mines.
Okay. I do? Okay. Oh, man, that ammo... The fact that ammo is timed is just perplexing.
Oh, it's not like a cooldown?
Yeah, what? Look at that yellow meter. That's my ammo. I have this gun until I don't.
That makes sense if you've got like a turret mounted on a car and get
come
a...
Come on! That is something else.
Most right. exciting thing that's happened all day right there.
Honestly, though, if I did get my hands on this when I was younger and entrenched in all PlayStation right. 2 games...
Did you get them all? Check over here. Oh, yeah, there it is.
Look at that. Is that the one that was up high?
No, it's not.
How do you know?
Because wait, oh, it could have been.
There you go.
I figured that would be the Meg Rider.
First person?
Meg Ryan. Okay. Yeah, it just floats down. What a confusing anyway.
Just don't put it there.
So
get the Meg Rider, alright.
Alright. I will.
Alright, let's see. Is there a place you haven't been here?
No. I think I've checked everything, but there might have been something I overlooked.
Maybe back that other way?
Do-do-do.
Or have you not gone all the way back here?
That's a circle.
Let me show you my circle.
The enemies are still there.
That's
cool.
This is going to the cave with the device.
Yeah, I just want to see if maybe there was something I missed. What's that thing?
Look ominous hole?
That wall. All right.
I think there's a costume party in the town and everyone's dressing alike.
I like the enemies stay dead.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I like that a lot.
No disappearing corpses. Something I liked about Doom.
What? Yeah, it's too bad we only have like 30-40 minutes to show this because there is so much to this game.
Is crafting it kind of... system?
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised. Like, seriously, it just goes everywhere.
Is that the Mag Rider, that platform?
That just...
Could
it be? This nope. thing?
Platform.
That just looks like a small cage, Jeff.
Oh. For
easy.
Birds and whatnot?
Yeah, easy mistake. Easy mistake. Don't worry about it. I'll just skate around you for a little
that
while.
It's so weird how he launches himself like that.
All right, this feels like the place I've been before. Right?
Yeah, it you're is. Just there. You okay. just made one big circle.
Yeah. I'm just looking for landmarks and stuff. Wait, hold on. So is that way?
Then
did I
this.
Go this way?
No, Mag Rider time.
Hey! So it's a different Mag Rider.
Oh, yeah. So those green pots are the mission objectives, right?
Yeah, I guess so. We're learning. Visual IDs.
We're learning.
This there's the Mag Rider. Look, it's a little beanie propeller thing.
Teach me how to use it. Power stick?
Power stick, okay.
Okay, I'll do that. Shield it up.
Shields up.
Where is that again? Is it... Did I lose my shield? It used to be circle. Just let me do
you
it.
You need a charge meter for your shield?
What is that? What is this?
Oh, it's the rain, so he puts on his hoodie, I think.
Oh, that's
really?
Kind of clever.
That's I amazing. Wish it always rained. Don't stop.
All right. Is this shield? Oh, that's shield energy. Okay, right. Makes sense. This makes sense, right?
Just shield up the blades.
Okay, yeah. And then do it up. Do the thing.
Is that a little faster?
I don't know. This thing seems pretty charged.
Yeah. You have 9 orange. So, keep that in mind.
All right, let me just see if I missed anything.
Fun with particles.
Ooh.
Use your shield energy to charge the power stick, then use the Meg Rider to obtain a cog.
You have to use it.
Oh, yeah.
Use it.
Sorry.
Press the use.
Get it!
What? Okay. We're learning.
Hang on, Tim.
I'm doing absolutely nothing.
Tim, hang on!
Oh, I haven't dropped the controller yet. What are those numbers?
Those are... How many Mag Riders you have left?
Oh. Yeah, Mag Riders.
All right, now let's go put that thing in the device.
Oh, I can't wait. That countdown is terrifying me.
It's the end of the world.
I don't like...
Majora's Moon is falling.
Yeah. Oh, the cogs are going to disappear out of your inventory.
You got to do it all again.
Yep.
Oh, I already went there.
This is not the right way.
I've been replaying Dead Space 1, and this is terrifying me more than Isaac running out of air.
And you've been playing Dead Space 3.
I have been, yes.
Lucky bastard.
If that really ends it, I'm going to be so bummed. Okay.
Oh my god.
One!
Throw the cogs!
They wouldn't time this whole thing, would they?
What the hell else is that?
Dang.
Okay. Let's assume that you're just a miracle man.
Wait, it's still going. What does that mean?
Get on there!
Your dreadlocks are critical. There you go.
What is it?
It is... It's hurting me.
What?
It's like a magical timer or something. Maybe you have to like get health or something. Maybe you're always kind of dying.
You need dreadlock juice or something?
What am I dodging? Are those actual things? Okay,
yes.
The water seems to be hurting. Okay,
oh, look out!
Fire's bad.
Really get to one
but
side.
So is water.
I can see why they took the cogs away.
Oh.
Like, this is just a bad idea.
And now it's just gone?
Don't worry about that, guys.
What was that?
Innovation that you can't even comprehend.
Yeah. The players aren't feeling enough right now. Let's just put an arbitrary timer on the screen.
Shield does nothing.
Yeah, that was a good little thought there, Tim.
Thank you. These rocks are bad, right?
Sure.
Okay. Oh, fire's bad.
There's a lot of really small ones.
And then there's water again. And then there's fire.
Fire. And then water. And then ice.
And the water hurts you?
And then rock.
I'm going to stay towards the back of the...
Oh, man. I was kidding about the rocks, guys.
Oh, geez. Oh.
Holy cow.
Did you just fall off?
Yeah, I got decimated.
That was kind of cool, though, right?
It was pretty intense.
Hmm.
Do you think that we can get past this part?
I don't know.
You know what? I'm a little skeptical.
Okay, all right, thank you.
So one of the cool things this game did, too, is they were able to put hundreds, maybe even thousands of enemies on screen at once.
Thousands?
Yeah, so you'll go into this like tomb, and there'll be just a sea of beetles in front of you. It was like this... replicating technology that they use with their character
models.
Did
they all have the exact same animation and movement?
No. They were moving around in different intervals, but they were the same models, yes.
Uh-huh.
This is awful.
No, it's
okay.
Not.
Sorry, all right.
You can't comprehend
okay.
What's going on.
All right, hold on. Okay.
Hey, Reiner, at some point, can we replay Dynasty Warriors 2?
Mm-hmm.
I would really love to do that. Speaking of so many enemies on screen at once.
So that was the first one on PlayStation 2, right? No.
Yeah?
The first one was a fighting game, right?
Yeah, and then it went Dynasty Warriors 2. Trying to track the Dynasty Warriors series is complicated.
And then they made Dynasty Warriors 2 15 times.
Yeah.
Then there was the Sengoku Basara series.
Stay.
Okay, okay, all right, okay. I can't really see where I am.
You're right there in the middle.
There we go.
Oh, wow. Dramatic. All right, this is kind of cool.
It's like Uncharted.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Where's Dan?
He's at home screaming, it's like Uncharted.
He felt something. Like,
oh,
what?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, you can shimmy. Look at that guy mining. Go home, dude. A tower just blew up.
That's your cue.
So, Tim, outside of being confused for 15 minutes, what are you thinking now?
I think that if I would have gotten my hands on this when I was into like Jack and Daxter and stuff and not having played Ratchet back in the day, I think I would have probably gotten into this. Don't destroy the pots. They're bad.
Yeah, those are the explodey pots with the fire.
Because you're really into yo-yos and dying, so this seems right in your wheelhouse.
Yeah, I think so. No, honestly, like I was, wasn't expecting much when we pulled this one out of the vault, but I'm surprised that no one ever talks about this game.
Including Trevor's.
Yeah, it absolutely bombed. Like, big time bomb.
It wasn't a cover, was it?
No.
Okay.
Nope, it was one of those games, you know, it was at E3 and people are like, oh, that looks interesting because they had a lot of different things they'd show off and then, you know, came out and was like, okay, let's see how it is. And then it was like, it's pretty good. You know, people are like, it's good. But then nobody bought it. Nobody talked about it after it came out.
One of the rare unlicensed games from Traveler's Tales. There aren't many of them.
No.
And this is the world they chose to create.
I wouldn't mind seeing them make their own universe in Lego.
It would be kind of cool.
I mean, they've been doing it so long with all these established brands. That'd be cool to see them. What they could do on their own.
Just to see what, like, maybe they could go undercover with this project.
Yeah, I was just thinking, like, Lego City is probably as close as we're going to get for a while. But even that, I mean, it's not like there's much Lego City lore established other than there's a pizza shop.
The Brickster. The Notorious Outlaw. Yeah.
Is that true?
Outside of the game? He stole pizzas.
Oh. Yeah.
Huh. And he's in the game?
Yeah. He's in Lego Island. I don't know.
Okay.
He's in Lego Universe Ugh. Sunny Undercover. Remember Lego Universe?
That was a big flop. Are you going to do what I think you're going
to
do?
Let's try to jump onto that platform.
Come on, Tim.
Hard to see.
There we go.
Get across.
Nice.
All right.
Oh, these guys are just doing their job. You're blowing everything up.
I admire these guys.
They're doing the equivalent of like when you walk by Reiner and I just mash on the space bar so you think I'm typing.
Jeez.
So those are explodey boxes, like POW boxes in Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah, I think I'm picking up on that a little bit. It's just like I don't know how to get around them in any way, shape, or form. Well, I guess there's this explanation.
Do this, dummy.
Ooh, look at the little mech guy. I'd want that job.
Walking through lava? Sounds tiring.
He doesn't even have that thumb to give a thumbs up for when he's feeling tired.
What are these guys doing? They are so just apathetic to my presence.
Oh. They're mining. What do you want them to?
Like the children in Temple of Doom.
I gotta say, the proximity, like explosions of these barrels is inconsistent and incredibly annoying.
Yeah. Well, they didn't do anything right there.
That's true. I've done that part a couple times, though. It's just, and also, like, there was, like, the...
Just stand between them. Let's see what happens.
Okay. No, I mean, I got it now.
Oh, man.
Ugh. Okay. It's these ones.
Well, they have a range around them.
I see it. I guess I just hate it. I don't know. I know I'm gonna get.
Hate it.
I'm gonna get some hate mail from all those Haven fans, and I'm
Haven
just gonna
Nets.
Say, listen, you say what you say about the game. It's your entitled to your opinion. I'm just gonna say, this is so Haven. That's so Haven.
That was awful.
Oh, you see, they just pop up behind you. Whatever.
Do you know what just happened there?
No, they just pop.
You hit that invisible one that made those other three populate.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Okay.
You fell for Traveler's Tales' trap.
Well, I guess I had that coming. And
let's see if
you
can hit this cog, and then we'll move on to our roulette. Okay, so those you can explode.
Use your
shoot
bullets.
Your thing?
Yeah. Don't you have that gun?
You have any shoot juice?
Those won't explode because they don't have...
the radius?
Yep, exactly.
You have to blow them up, otherwise they'll be fine.
It's TNT versus Nitro from Crash. Reiner's right.
Oh, okay.
TNT, yeah, not POD. Pow. Kablooey.
Kablooey.
Biff. Bam.
I'm really enjoying watching this again. We have our showdown coming up in March.
That's right.
I might think about this one.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Have you made your choice? How many games are in the running right now?
I do. There's one very big one that I think I'd like to do.
Tomba 2?
No, I'm not going to mention it yet until the showdown.
It's Morrowind.
Cool. Well, look forward to that.
All right. Well, Tim, that was a struggle at first, but you got the hang of it a little bit now that we figured out what the pots do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Kind of cool. I still think it looks decent. I don't know what you guys think. And honestly, I don't care. Let's move on to roulette. All right, this is our roulette, and wow, we're looking at a Game Gear game.
Yeah.
We're playing Sonic the Hedgehog 2 on Game Gear.
Finally.
we finally got to it.
First Game Gear game ever.
Look at this little story setup. Not even Sonic 2 on the Genesis has this. Coniac, pinch it. I'm still trying to run.
I'm so small.
Sonic doesn't... you know what? Actually, this game used to be just about me. I think... I'm going to pretend to run for a little bit and... Yeah.
What's going on with his nose there? It's like Pinocchio. It just keeps shooting out.
And why does he keep breaking the fourth wall looking at us?
Well, he tapped his... What at us?
He's like,
should I do?
He told us to have peace forever.
Yep.
So the Game Gear, while also having color, whereas the Game Boy was monochromatic, was where you went for handheld Sonic. And if you followed Sonic to like the Game Gear, it was complete disappointment. I sold my Game Boy in order to get a Game Gear and like one Sonic game. and it was the worst decision I think I've ever made in my gaming career.
This just looks like Sonic. I don't know why you're so
those
upset.
Those decisions are the worst. To have to sell a system to get another one because you're excited about a game.
Yeah.
And then it turns out to be a bust.
Seriously, what didn't you like about this?
So Tim had a Game Gear. I had a Game Gear.
I had a Game Gear briefly.
Yeah, it was my first gaming system.
Oh,
yeah.
Really? Mortal Kombat on it was awful.
So, Cork, did you play any of these Sonic games?
No.
This is not good Sonic. There's no momentum. The screen doesn't scroll right. Like, if you played on Genesis and that's how you fell in love with Sonic, this is not the game for you at all. It's a pretty demented version of it.
Is this based on any stage in Sonic 2?
Underground.
No, not really. There was no lava stage. There was Marble Zone in Sonic 1, and then there was like Lava Reef Zone in Sonic.
Lava Reef?
Yeah, Lava Reef Zone. That's from Sonic and Knuckles. And okay. I think that the fire stages might have skipped 2 and 3. I mean, I guess there's some fire in... there's fire hazards and stuff. But.
Tim, I'll say as far as a setting, this is more interesting as a first level than any other Sonic game.
Mm-hmm. You think so? Just not having the green right away?
Yeah. Hmm. That's all peaceful and calm, and there's little rabbits and birds.
Yeah, you start with a minecart level.
Yeah, this is like lava and minecarts and spikes falling on your head.
Also, it shows Tails. Tails was just kidnapped. He's nowhere.
Those are precious Tails memories.
Oh, when they used to go on these deadly minecart rides.
It's his Tails puppet that he carries around with him just to remind him of the good times they had.
Yeah, they went into that in the animated series.
They're friends, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. What else would they be?
I don't understand. Wow. Yeah, plus this music is so much better than the Green Hill Zone music. It's just fantastic.
So, no spin dash. Unlike,
Whoa!
Sorry, we'll
breaking
actually
the illusion.
Assume. You don't never know what's going to pause in these, Wait, hold on, look at the pattern changes in the wall there. I have an idea here. He's just not for it.
So, I want to say that you can't spin dash because of button limitation, but that's not really the case, is it? Because it was all
the
same
you press
button?
Down. There's one button. Sonic. Yeah, it's jump, and you press down and jump, and you'd spin dash.
Right. They just realized it was unnecessary, and they got rid of it from here on out for the Sonic series.
Yep. Yeah, this is...
So, what's your opinion on Super Mario Land, then?
I hate it. The first Super Mario Land is awful.
Okay.
I beat it after the fact. I didn't have it with the original
Game
Boy.
After what fact?
After the fact of, like...
Puberty.
Three generations removed from the Game Boy.
All right. Hold on, Tim. I see a theme here.
Okay.
That game was fun, but it wasn't up to the standard of the others, right?
No.
Is this game fun, just not up to the standard of the Genesis games?
I don't really enjoy this.
Okay, but stop. Compared to every other Game Gear game, I'd argue this is probably one of the best. This
looks
great.
It's still a pile of crap. I mean,
relatively, but you can't look at it that way, Tim.
Well, objectively being bad. Well, okay, you mentioned Mario Land. Mario Land 2, 6 Golden Coins is one of my favorite Mario games.
It's fantastic. Yeah.
And the difference in quality between Mario Land and Mario Land 2 is crazy. So they're capable of doing something better than this. I mean,
is it hard to play the game with your nose turned so high up to it?
Wait, what's that?
You're being a snob, Tim.
But
because Mario Land 2 is great and there's nobody denying that, it doesn't mean that they can create a fantastic Sonic game for the Game Gear.
What do you guys have to gain from defending a Game Gear title?
This
passable?
Is just baffling to me.
Yeah, this game actually was my childhood. This was one of the few games I owned for Game Gear.
I went from owning... Okay, so Mario Land 2.
Yeah.
And Link's Awakening.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Better games than this, maybe?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Well, then... So, are you just screwed, then, at this point? Yeah, you are. If you don't make that jump, you're just done. There's no other alternate way
up
there.
It's like Dark Souls. I don't see. Baby.
Now you're Dark Souls.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing. I left behind Mario Land 2 and Link's Awakening for this because I wanted higher quality games on my, my handheld, and I was dead wrong.
Are you noticing the colors, though? I really want you to pay attention to how blue Sonic is.
He's cerulean.
He really pops on the screen.
Did you actually own this game? What Sonic games did you have for Game Gear?
I had most of them. Okay. I had Triple Trouble for sure. Mm-hmm.
And you're welcome.
That was important to me because I read the comics and there was characters in the comics that were introduced, like this weird Australian dude and like a croc. And thanks for the help, Robotnik. Oh.
Just right. Thanks, dogs.
Dogs? Oh, yeah, because Robotnik.
Right?
Yeah, dogs did the voice for Robotnik.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, Elliot played Sonic on Dreamcast.
Uh-huh.
In Sonic Adventure, and Dogs Bauer played Eggman.
Wow!
You want to give this?
Big was Sanjay John.
Okay, here you go, Jeff Cork. Go ahead and play some Sonic 2 for Game Gear, buddy.
I'm going to have some fun.
Jeff Cork, I'm really looking forward to watching you play this. I'm looking at the smile on your face growing. It's becoming like the Joker's.
Look at you, I'm playing Sonic.
You're so fast.
This is no worse than any other Sonic
game. Oh, you're
so
good, Jeff.
Look at me go.
Don't jump into the spikes, bud.
I won't.
So I remember I had this game, and then later on I had Sonic Blast, which is funny because Traveler's Tales, who made the previous game, they made Sonic 3D Blast. But then the Game Gear version was called Sonic Blast, and it was also not great.
I played 3D Blast on Genesis.
Okay, here we go.
And suffered that game.
What is that game like? Is it actually 3D?
Isometric. Top-down perspective.
Oh, that's right. I remember seeing that. Yeah, yeah.
We should look at it sometime. It is a bizarre little anomaly of a game.
I will say Sonic has been very underrepresented in our replay history.
Tim hates Sonic, I hear.
That's true.
Look at that. I had so
like
much fun.
Run.
There we go.
You did 44 seconds. Pretty good, Jeff. Not How's bad. It feel compared to the Genesis games?
Identical.
Oh, yeah. Just absolutely. Like, maybe we should bust out the Master System game. Would you have defended that, too?
No, that one's no good.
The Master System Sonic the Hedgehog game. But for some reason, I don't honestly see that much of a difference between the Master System game and this in terms of quality. Like, this is worse than the Genesis games. That is why I'm trying to get through here. Are you not agreeing with me here?
I agree with you.
And it's bad and not a good reason to own a Game Gear.
No, but if you own a Game Gear, this is probably one of the best games you can get for. I mean, what else was that?
That is not an endorsement at all.
Look, I don't support this game in any way. I didn't come in here defending or planning to defend it, but I owned it. I remember enjoying it as a kid.
You're a dumb kid.
Yeah, no, a super dumb kid. I also played the heck out of Bart versus the World on Game Gear. That was my go-to game.
Oh, well.
Bart versus the World is
an awful game. Style. I put that on NES. Yeah.
But you're forgetting that you can become Bartman, so therefore it is kind of cool.
Or I'm thinking of Bart versus the Space Mutant.
A lot of things.
That was really cryptic and weird, and you had to, like, there's, like, purple space.
There's, like, cameos from people that were unrecognizable. Like, that version of Mo was really bizarre.
Is it like a black Mo?
Yes.
Like Black Smithers?
Yeah.
So I'm going to point out that you saw Tim pause earlier. We're playing the Sonic Gems collection on GameCube, which has all sorts of old classics that you probably won't see again anytime
There's
soon.
One classic on there.
Gem.
Which is
There was Sonic CD. That was the way to play Sonic CD. I remember I got this from the rental store, and I played through Sonic CD. I'm like, oh, this is pretty fun. And then there's Sonic Racing and Sonic Fighters, which I had played in arcades when they were in arcades. Those are like the worst damn games. They recently ported them to like XBLA and stuff. If you want a weird, bizarre look at this anomaly and just how bad the series got and how much the reputation was tarnished, take a look at Racers, and maybe we'll take a look at it sometime. But honestly, the Gems collection is anything but, except for CD.
That's on the back of the box, I think.
Anything but.
One last question for you, Tim. You had this game. Did you complete it?
I beat most of these games, I think. The ones that I could beat. I mean, they were really tough.
Did you have a red face the whole time? And like a little vein?
A rump.
And Tim.
There's a little thought bubble that was shaped like a heart that had a little picture of Mario in
it. Or a storm cloud.
Yeah.
just tapping his foot the whole time, staring at a mirror.
I think I beat...
I'm going to draw this when I get home.
I beat this, and I think I might have beat Triple Trouble, and I don't know how deep I got into the other ones because I sold the thing before I was able to buy any more games. They're so bad, you guys.
All right. Leave it alone, Tim.
Yeah, I think we can all agree that this is a decent looking game for Game Gear.
It's fine. That guy's from Alex Kidd in Enchanted Castle. Little ant lion dude.
What is that?
This
is
a weird squid. The first time I ever seen
crab
captivity.
Thing.
One of those ant lions.
Oh, wait. You have to dodge those balls so that it hits the dumb crab thing.
Yep.
I guarantee that's what's going on with that.
Alex Kidd also has a dung beetle, which is pretty awesome enemy.
He eats rice cakes.
Pushing a big ball of poo. The end.
Well, I don't think we're going to see what happens to that weird crab.
You don't
want to
see
thing.
It?
He's we like, do, but it's not going to happen.
He's around the corner.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. We'll see you next week on Replay.